I had undergone hair transplantation exactly 2 months back, but still I didn't see any hair growth. I can't see any hair growth in my head. I called the doctor and he is saying I need to wait 3 to 4 months. I agreed with his word and I'm now under medication for his prescription after hair transplant surgery. The worst thing is now I am not able to find the transplanted hair roots. Is this normal after transplantation? The root, small holes of transplanted hair, have totally vanished from my head.
Thank you for your question. It is very understandable to be nervous and concerned that you don't see the hair follicles that were transplanted, and that you certainly did the right thing by communicating with your doctor about the future and to anticipate that hair growth will occur several months later. So to understand what is going on and what the history is of a typical hair transplant is that, yes, once the hair is transplanted, it can grow for a few weeks. But then it goes through a normal growth cycle of shedding. And the normal hair growth cycle is basically a growing phase which represents 85 to 90% of your hairs. It's called the anagen phase, or the growing phase, lasts 3 to 5 years. And then it goes through what's called the catagen and telogen phases, where it stops growing and it sheds for several months. So what you're experiencing is the several months part of that growth phase. And then once the hair starts to grow, it grows at about a centimeter a month. So it is certainly unsettling to not see your hair and imagine that the grafts didn't take or other things like that. In our practice, we actually use a material called extracellular matrix, which is advanced wound healing that seems to help our patients recover a little bit faster in many of our hair transplants. We find that our donor incisions heal better, and when I perform the surgery and I harvest the strip and I do a very nice plastic surgery closure and we place our hair grafts, we use this material called extracellular matrix, which heals by duplication through the recruitment of adult stem cells. So many of our patients find that they don't go through as much of a shedding phase as is typical in a hair restoration procedure. Nonetheless, with or without this additional technology, it is still normal to go through a phase where you don't see the hairs, but you can be pretty confident that there are a lot of hairs from the transplant that are going to be growing. There is certainly a lot of variability between patients and transplant practices in terms of the percentage of hairs that grow back. But I always tell our patients that you really have to wait a full year to understand exactly how much did take. As a side note, I can also mention that when we do our hair transplants and we use this extracellular matrix, we get kind of a dual benefit in that not only do we get better healing of the grafts, but we also restore hair that was thinning. And so the combination effect of restoring thinning hair with additional hair grafts seems to generate considerably nicer results than is seen with typical surgeries. Again, your concern is natural, and a little bit of patience will allow you to appreciate the benefit of the transplant and then make a decision after approximately a year from the date of your transplant as to how, if you need an additional transplant procedure. So I'd recommend you just be patient for now. Continue communicating with your doctor. I hope that was helpful. Thank you for your question.